Be more specific, Trambian. So let's talk a little bit about the changes they made to Tassadar in case you don't know by now. So first and foremost, they kind of touched up everything Tassadar does. His basic attacks to start off with now do 7 times less damage. 7 times less damage. From about 70 damage, it's down to 10. Yeah. But he attacks 4 times faster. Okay, attack speed. Right? That's good. And he also channels that beam now. It's a beam channel, like you saw. You might remember it. It used to be a talent back in the day. For Tassadar, it got removed at some point. I don't remember exactly when. And it slows the target by 25% as you channel on the target. Okay, so that's to start off with the basic attacks. Moving on to his Q ability. Plasma Shield now has got an increased cooldown in mana cost. It used to be 40 mana, now it's 50 mana. The cooldown used to be 5 seconds, now it's 8 seconds. But it grants default lifesteal for the duration, okay? And I think the amount, the actual shield amount has been buffed as well to match the cooldown and the brand new mana cost. But again, it has default 20% lifesteal from basic attacks. His W ability, Psionic Storm, now it has a backdraft effect. It will deal more damage the more hits it gets on a target, okay? So subsequent consecutive hits on the same target will deal more damage, okay? That's for Psionic Storm. His E ability now grants default movement speed. So basically what they did is they incorporated some of the talents we used to pick up on Tassadar directly into his default kit. So now when you press your E ability, I think they messed around. Yeah, they messed around the cooldown as well. It was 20 seconds, now it's 30 seconds. Okay, so keep that one in mind. And now, like I said, it gets you default movement speed. As you saw there, I was able to pop it and move very quickly. Heroic abilities. Let me see, what do I remember? Oh yes, the wall now passively grants increased slow, I think, from your basic attacks, from your brand new beam, but we'll check in game. I don't remember perfectly right now. And Archon, now they played around with Archon as well. Now what Archon does, they also played a little bit with the damage and stuff like that, but what Archon does now is that it resets the cooldown of your E ability, which considering is a 30 second cooldown, it's a big deal. So theoretically, if you want to make a glorious escape, because I can't see why else would you use it, you can go E, okay, dimensional shift, R into Archon, and dimensional shift again, okay, because again, popping Archon will reset the cooldown of your E ability. Also, they played around with pretty much every single goddamn talent there was on Tassadar, alright? Now, here's a spoiler alert, he's a bit under-tuned from certain points of view, but what I'm interested in, is this the gameplay different, or am I still a bloody shield bot? I don't know about you, but I never enjoyed playing a shield bot. However, our Tassadar had one redeeming quality from a gameplay perspective. You could make awesome plays with the wall. And suddenly, the support is now the MVP with a professional wall, put down, his team wins, etc, etc. Okay, that's what I liked about Tassadar. He is a shield bot, no question about it. But, you could make plays with the wall. So there's that to keep in mind. Well, let's switch the overlay and get the gameplay. Talent level 1, like I said, they're all new, brand new quest talents, and they're free stages. What I like to call free stage talents. You get 2 sets of rewards. For example, this one on hitting 500 enemies, and the second reward at 1000 enemies. It refers to Psionic Storm size and damage. We're gonna go with Kaidarim Resonance. Regen Globes grants you additional 50% mana. After you get 20 Regen Globes, Plasma Shield retains 50% of its value after it. Oh god, I just wanted to read these things. Christ, why you guys gotta be like that? Why you gotta kill everything so quickly? I was being busy. Yeah, I got him! I got you, Danny boy! Kill him as well! Q over the wall! Kill him at least! Daniel, if you go in ham, at least kill him! Alright. Where was I? Oh yes! And after collecting 40 Regen Globes, Plasma Shield persists indefinitely. Forever. The entire amount, okay? So, the entire amount. What else do I want to say? Oh yes, Temper as well. This one is cool as well. This one is about your beam, but I don't really use this one. I think we need this one for the mana. Oh, hold on. Shit. Got you. Gotta pay a little bit of attention on the gameplay for a second here, folks. Now, well, I kindly ask my teammates that they gotta keep in mind that now I have 8 seconds on cooldown on shield. And they always have lifesteal from it. Also, my basic attacks basically do nothing. So that's one to keep in mind as well. Here you go, shield. Alright, so I was talking about Templars. Fine, you die. I can't be arsed if you're that silly. Attacking enemy heroes restores 4 mana per second. After spending 30 seconds attacking heroes, distortion beam rage is increased by 1. Here you go. And after spending 60 seconds attacking heroes, distortion beam range is increased also by an additional 1. So overall, you're gonna get 2 more range. Here, go attack something. Right. And the one I picked up is usually the one I prefer to play on the Nuke Tesla. Hold on, we're fighting here, actually. Okay. We got Tribute on the bottom lane, so we're gonna head there since there's no more globe to be had here. Give this guy a shield, make sure he doesn't die. Level 4! Or let's finish up with level 1, shall we, first. So the one I... Happy now. He's dead. This one! Okay, I guess I don't get confused. He has vision as well. What was I saying? Yes, the final talent at level 1. So, regen glows grant additional 50% mana. After collecting 20 regen glows, plasma shield retains 50% of the value, and after 40 regen glows, it will retain full value. So we're gonna have to hunt down regen glows. I have tested Tassadar in damage mode. I have taken all the damage talents possible. He pulls out pretty bad damage. What you saw earlier in the earlier game when I was top damage for my team, that was my team being completely worthless, not Tassadar being good. In damage, that is. We're gonna go with Kala's Embrace. This will increase the lifesteal to 40% because we have an Illidan, and that will be extremely useful for him. Don't worry about the Tassadar attacking you. Okay, never worry about it. Tassadar does nothing with his basic attacks. Silence, but that's okay. Should have started off with a stun. That would have guaranteed her the kill. So like I see, I do nothing. Look at the damage I have. See? Nothing. Absolutely nothing. I do no damage with my basic attacks now. You're basically a slow bot. Okay, you just attack the slow. Oh, fuck you. Sucker. Right, next talent. We're gonna go with the Psionic Projection. Increases the cast range of Plasma Shield and Psionic Storm by 40%. This will allow you to further stay in the backline, save allies, clutch heals, clutch shields. Not heals. Yeah, you get it. Yes, I have tried damage build, Jarl underline Lul. It's pathetic. It's absolutely pathetic. So no. He actually has less damage than he had before. I was hoping when I heard of the rework and I heard some of the changes they did that I will finally get to see my Tassadar from the early technical alpha. I don't know how many of you guys were playing back then, but during the technical alpha, Tassadar wasn't really much of a support. What Tassadar was back then was a sustain... damage dealer powerhouse. Okay, he had a lot of damage, tons upon tons of damage, thanks to his whatchamacallit. Oh shit! I got you with a shield. Maybe not. Got you with a shield. He had a lot of damage because of his Psionic Storm build. Okay, he used to play Tassadar into Psionic Sword. A lot of damage on the ground was really, really cool. And that's what I was hoping you could do now. All right, I don't want to be a shield bot anymore. I'm tired of being a goddamn shield bot. With the only redeeming quality being the wall. Unfortunately, that is not the case. Damage Tassadar sucks balls. Look. For the sake of... Yeah, I'm going with Force Wall. At least I can make plays like this or try to. Staying in front. Slowing this guy. Nope. Got you. So yeah, that's what I tested so far. As far as healing is concerned, because after all we are a support, well, it's still Tassadar. He gets healing through his shield. So it's pretty much, well, you're still a heal bot. No, not even a heal bot, a shield bot. And that's all, boys. I'm rather disappointed because I was hoping for at least a gameplay change for Tassadar. Let me at least have the option to go damage, you know? At least that, please. possible. But no, don't worry about it. We don't have that option. Why don't you charge in, Sober? It's a 2-on-3, you're the only mini. Get the fuck in there. There you go. Slow him down. No, you're not going in. Not going in. Slow down, Valera. Here comes Zilada. Go. Go, Zilada. Come on, you got 40% life still, man. It doesn't get better than that. So yeah, you see, this is what happens on the PTR. What's happening right now is not really okay either. It's pretty much what happened earlier, only backwards. You know? Because of the low player base this game has, sadly. Low. Oh boy. Poor guy. Good kill. Gotta shield a little bit. There you go. Now go nuts. She obviously played melee main, which is not good. Sober. Sober! If you would have reacted quicker, perhaps we would have survived that. Perhaps. Oh, enemy team is cut. I'm okay. Haha, sucker. Easy gameplay. I'm out of here, bye. Nullification, it's a sort of shrink ray, activate to reduce the damage target the enemy hero deals by 75% for 3 seconds. Does it any point? Do you think there's any point to me picking up this Abbey stop damage, really? Deep shift. Fine, deep shift so I can get in front of them. Hey, Siren, you! Hello, Lazar, long time no see. I'm glad to hear your voice again. Oh. Well, you run at a few. People usually can't stand my voice. I can't hear me. Not a particularly beautiful voice. So yeah, I don't know what else to tell you about the reward. I'm simply disappointed in it. You know, I'm a little bit salty. We're gonna have to excuse. I was hoping we can play Tester some other way. I mean, the only positive thing I see in this rework is the fact that I got shields. I got beam on my whatchamacallit. I got a nice cool beam. See, I got a cool beam. My auto attacks are a beam. See, it's super cool. It looks cool. But I knew it from before. So, yeah. Gotcha. Cool down on plasma shield, boys. I can't help you. Run. Careful at the Abbey mines, though. I guess I should go back. Right here in the middle, where it's nice and dangerous. These wings are just Lazar, why do you play this PTR crap? Well, Tranbian, to answer you honestly, people expect me to take a look at all the new stuff as fast as possible. That's why I play this PTR crap. Would you take Val over other stealth characters 100%? Zia 719, yes, I would. I definitely would, friend. What, did I not get the globe? Shit, I was out of range. What else should I say? I don't know. Oh, don't worry about the numbers when it comes to Tassadar's rework, okay? In general, when you see a rework, you don't really need to worry about this doesn't do enough, this does too much, etc, etc. The only thing that matters, from my point of view at least, is the gameplay. If the gameplay is the same, then what is the point of the goddamn rework anyway? I'm doing the same thing, only now it's with different talents and which pretty much do the same thing. Nah. As for me, like I told you, the gameplay is mostly the same. Now it does matter to basic attack heroes to help your team, you know, help your team get kills, slow them down, etc. Because you got a beam, but you do no damage. I don't know. Don't worry about Tassadar's basic attacks, okay? They do nothing. Trust me when I tell you they do nothing. I don't enjoy these stomps. This is stupid. Talent level 16, this is vulnerable, physical vulnerable, okay? It will apply a vulnerable effect, but only from basic attacks and stuff. And considering my team composition, it would be good. Not that the game is not over anyway. High Templar sentry. I don't know, man. High Templars kind of felt more exciting in StarCraft than here. I don't understand the point of this rework. I really don't. Yay, me, MVP.